Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the seventh video in the STM32 Ethernet series using the W5500 module. In the previous videos of this series, we have already covered how to configure the W5500 module, set up TCP and HTTP servers on STM32, and communicate with the HTTP web server in a dynamic way. Today, we will continue building on that knowledge. In this video, we will learn how to use the STM32 as an MQTT client. We will see how to publish and subscribe to different topics, and also understand how to process and use the data received from those subscriptions. We will build this project on top of the first part of the series, since that project already contains all the basic initialization needed for the W5500 module. We will simply add the MQTT-related files to extend its functionality. The hardware connection will remain exactly the same as in Part 1. The W5500 module is connected through SPI, and an USB to TTL module is connected through UART for logging and debugging. Let's open Cube IDE now. Here, I have the project from Part 1 of the series already opened. Let's rename it to Part 7 so that we can continue working on it without creating everything again. Make sure to check the Update References box, so the IDE automatically updates all internal project references wherever required. Alright, the renaming is done, so let's start by copying the required files into this new project. Open the I/O library that we downloaded in the first part of the series. Go inside the Internet folder. Here, you will find the MQTT folder, which contains all the files needed to run the MQTT client on STM32. Let's copy this folder into our project. Place it inside the Ethernet folder that we created earlier in Part 1. I have also prepared MQTT example files to show how the library is used in a simple and clear manner. So let's copy these example files as well. You can download these example files from the project link provided in the description of this video. Alright, now let's take a look at the MQTT example.c file. At the beginning of the file, we need to define the socket that will be used for MQTT. As I explained earlier, the W5500 chip provides a total of 8 hardware sockets. Out of these 8 sockets, sockets 6 and 7 are already reserved for DHCP and DNS tasks. Because of this, we have only 6 sockets available for our own use, which are sockets 0 to 5, and we can choose any one of these for the MQTT connection. I have decided to assign socket 0 for MQTT in this project. Next, if you plan to use the broker's hostname, for example, test.mosquitto.org, you must make sure to keep this statement defined. If instead you want to use the broker's IP address directly, you can comment out this line so the code uses the IP address instead of the hostname. Since I am going to use the hostname, I will leave this statement defined. With this enabled, the STM32 will perform a DNS lookup first, resolve the hostname, and then store the obtained IP address in a buffer for later use. Next, we define the MQTT broker port here. I have set the port to 1883, which is the standard port used for simple, unencrypted, and unauthenticated MQTT connections. After that, you need to define the client ID for the STM32. This helps the broker identify the device when it connects. The first function we have is MQTT network init. This function initializes the MQTT socket and sets up a basic connection path toward the broker. Next is the MQTT connect broker function. This function allows the client to actually connect to the MQTT broker. Inside this function, you can configure the MQTT connect packet, including the MQTT version, keep alive interval, clean session flag, client ID, and other similar settings. You can adjust even more options that are available in the connect data structure if your application needs them. Next, we have the MQTT publish function, which is used to publish a message to a chosen topic. The parameters here are simple: the topic name you want to publish to, and the message you want to send. The quality of service is set to 0 by default, but you can change it depending on your requirement. If the publish operation is successful, the message will be printed on the serial console as confirmation. Just like publishing, there is also a function for subscribing to a topic. The parameter for this function is the topic name that the STM32 should listen to. Here again, the QoS level is set to 0. Message arrived is the callback function that handles all received MQTT messages. This callback allows you to process the data received by the STM32 client whenever a subscribed topic sends a message. You can even use the same callback to manage messages from multiple topics. In such situations, you can check the topic name inside the callback to filter and process messages separately. For example, if the incoming message is from the topic ControllersTech/sub, we can move ahead with additional checks or actions. Here, we will extract the payload received and store it in a separate buffer for further processing. To make use of the received message, I am checking whether the incoming payload is on or off. Based on that value, we call the LED control function to turn the LED on or off on the STM32 board. If you want to subscribe to several topics, you simply call the subscribe function multiple times. You can also create separate callbacks for each topic, and in that case, you will not need to check the topic name manually inside the callback. Anyway, I will keep the current configuration for now, and I will also demonstrate how to subscribe to multiple topics in this example. Next, we have the MQTT yield function, which is responsible for handling all incoming MQTT packets. Whenever the client receives a new message, this function makes sure the correct callback is triggered. Because of this, MQTT yield must be called regularly, either inside the main while loop or inside a separate free RTOS task if you are using an RTOS. Without calling it often, the client will not receive messages on time. Finally, we have an example here that shows how to use all these functions together. This example is only for reference, because I will write the final code directly inside the main file. So let's begin by including the MQTT example.h file. Now inside the main function, after initializing the W5500 module, call the function MQTT network init. This will set up the MQTT client and start the process of connecting to the broker. Next, call MQTT connect broker, which sends the actual MQTT connect request to the broker. Once the broker accepts this request, the client is officially connected. After the connection is ready, the client will subscribe to a topic so it can start receiving messages. Now we will manage the rest of the communication inside the while loop. Inside the loop, we call MQTT yield to process incoming messages and keep the MQTT connection active. We will also publish data to a topic every 5 seconds. Since I want the client to send fresh data every time, I am defining a counter variable that increases inside the while loop. Remember that MQTT messages must be sent in ASCII format, so the counter value needs to be converted to a string. We can do this easily using the sprintf function. Let's include the standard io.h file to use sprintf. Alright, the client setup is complete now. We initialized the client, sent the connect packet to the broker, subscribed to a topic, and inside the while loop, we published data every 5 seconds to another topic. I have defined an external function here to control the LED. Now let's create this function inside the main file. Inside the function, we will update the LED pin depending on the message received from MQTT. That is all. Now let's build the project and flash it to the board. Open the serial console to view the logs. Here, you can see the full initialization process of the MQTT client. It first performs a DNS lookup for the broker, gets the broker's IP address, and then establishes a connection with it. Next, the client subscribes to the selected topic, and after that, it begins publishing data every 5 seconds. You can clearly see that the data being published updates each time, because the count variable increases on every loop. Now, let's open another MQTT client so we can monitor these messages. I have the mosquitto client installed on my computer, so I will use it to subscribe to the same topic that the STM32 is publishing to. As you can see, the mosquitto client is receiving the messages sent by the STM32 client without any issue. Now I will open one more client, and this time I will publish messages to the topic that the STM32 client is subscribed to. I will send the message hello from another client. You can see that the STM32 has received the message from this new client. This confirms that the STM32 is successfully receiving data sent to that topic. Now let's test controlling the LED by sending the on and off commands. When the external client sends the off command, the LED turns off, and when it sends the on command, the LED turns on. If any other message is sent, the LED does not react, which shows that we are checking only for valid commands. This also shows that we can control any STM32 peripheral using data received over MQTT. As I mentioned earlier, the STM32 can subscribe to multiple topics, so let's see how to do that as well. To subscribe to another topic, we simply call the subscribe function again, and provide the new topic name as the parameter. Since we are using only one callback for all the subscriptions, we could add a separate check inside the callback to detect messages from the second topic. But for now, I will skip that check and simply show that the STM32 can receive messages from both topics. Here, you can see that the STM32 has subscribed to both topics. Now let's publish messages to test this. First, I am publishing to the original topic. The data is received correctly by STM32, and the LED responds as expected. Next, I am publishing to the second topic. The STM32 receives this message too, and you can also see the topic name displayed in the log. However, even though the message from the second topic is received, it cannot control the LED. This is because our callback only checks for the first topic when deciding whether to turn the LED on or off. So this is how you can make the STM32 subscribe to multiple topics and handle all messages using a single callback function, simply by checking the topic names. We were able to implement the MQTT client on STM32 using the W5500 Ethernet module. We saw how to publish and subscribe to topics, and how to use the incoming data from another MQTT client to control peripherals. This is it for this video. I hope everything was explained clearly. You can download the project from the link provided in the description. Feel free to leave your questions in the comments. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.